Both our eyes are red, but you're high and I'm crying. You're trying to forget, but it hits me every time.
이 아이트가 나왔죠.
Right hand holds your left sleeve.
By your sweet princess Helga. Silky smooth, super soft, your sweet princess Ilka. Wisdom, analogy, not theology, reconnaissance, intelligence, all packed up and shared with you and by your sweet princess Ilka here in my Atakalacho. I spent my entire life for people around me to get a little bit of awareness what's going on around them, to grasp a place in which they are not the center of the universe and nobody else exists, but that there are other people with the same freaking fucking needs. My entire life to bring awareness. Of course, this is harsh when you see me, because then you can see how despicable those people might be. And they might have seen too, or maybe not. Really, the only despicable person I saw in Siemens was the chauffeur of the general director, Pauli's chauffeur. I cannot possibly explain why I think so. He looked like a classical Nachayote. Maybe he wasn't bad looking. He wasn't overweight like Felix, and he wasn't old like the other one. He looked like a mean motherfucker, an evil bitch. Yeah, maybe not exactly from the Zauber Curl, but almost. Vulgar. Shit. Now I do have to talk about him. I treated him with disrespect, but I did not talk with him. I must have seen him once. Maybe he came once up to the office or so. Or maybe I saw him, but I don't talk to him. Of course he spread lies in Siemens. What Coca told me. And then they shut him up. Okay, that's not what I wanted to talk about, but that's what it is. Pay attention, what needs to be said. Now I have to accept, because I had a few nice strings in my head before I opened the video in which to engage. And now I have to go somewhere else. Engaging. When you know how to knit a sweater, it's one, I don't even know how it's called in English. Masche, masche, masche. One little knot after another. We call it masche. It has to be engaging to make a whole. A communication, a conversation has to be engaged to make a whole. That thing recognizing Latin America, la Latinoamericanidad, that happened in Mexico. That we are part of a whole. Many countries we form this one place. It happened in people who studied, right? People who educated themselves. People who would assist to the movie theaters, to this Mostra of Cinema, because those were 21 films depicted in 21 days from different countries. When the Argentinian came and he said, if I don't have beef, it's like I haven't eaten. I accepted. That's where he comes from. It almost sounds like the German asshole who says, I have to have my food at the table at a certain time. But it's not. It's just different. When people have children, they must educate them. But that is the issue right now. Man, it's like the pest that come around, right? More and more. Golly. Yeah, and they're so proud that they stole from me. and continue doing so. Because they don't think, they don't look, they don't acknowledge. What just happened? They don't see what happened with green? They don't understand? They don't want to, and that is the issue. They never ever want to look into their own little places. They don't wish to look to me or to other people. They don't want to see other people. Ever. They ever, never ever look at me. Because that frightens them. Because you must look inside to understand what this is all about. And that is the one place they never want to go. Inside. They have no place here, they're unworthy. What can they possibly educate anybody? You gotta show what you know, but they don't know anything. Ignorance going rampant. Absolutely unacceptable. Creating more dumb soldiers. Look, I told you in the previous video, Anna talked to me. Anna, the music teacher. Yeah, to me she talked. Because she knew I would understand. Because there's intellectuality, and intellectuality recognizes intellectuality. Because I'm also open. I'm receptive. Because she is not obnoxious. I don't know why she started talking to me. I didn't ask. But she did. So I opened my eyes wide, wide open. And receive her, so she feels invited to share. It's lonely as a teacher. Who can listen to her? Who wants to know? That was not the Montessori school. That was right before. I think I was just kind of waiting for summer to end so Montessori could start. I have no clue why he was there for just a very short amount of time. I felt like it was time for him to share. Yeah, I had to thoroughly listen to my heart. Is this a good moment or is it not? To my heart. That was, he was like maybe just three. Because that happened in summer. And she went in a little earlier, 2.5. Because when he entered at 3, I don't know if she entered right away. Or 2. Then she too went, but Montessori wasn't available yet for her because it starts at 3, now I remember. But right down the very street, yeah, the same street where Gina had like a house and first the apartment. Yeah, that is the very street on the other side. There, some woman, some mother opened a school because she owned a terrain, a large garden, and Sophie went there. It felt right, it was just, it was not education, but she was not even 3 yet. She was more advanced than he was. So it felt right to allow her to be with other children, and she liked it. It was more like a children deposit where they play games, and it's also okay. It's all very good. Yeah, and when she left, her particular teacher, no, not the mother. I had not much respect for the mother who opened the school. The school was pretty, lots of greens. And the teachers were like dedicated, yes, loving the children. So Sophie's teacher cried when I took Sophie out to Montessori. She fell in love with Sophie. She cried. I can emphasize. Because when you pay attention, and when you get paid attention, when you got attention from someone who's love, it's amazing. And in a world where there was no trauma yet, she was open, Sophie. It's amazing. Super sweet. Yeah, when that happened to change, right? Not everybody has the strength I do to maintain that integrity of the character and the strengths despite the adversities around. Well, she wasn't supposed to. She came here to do that, and that's all. Well, that, whatever that is, she had to do support. And he, I don't know, maybe no matter what, how great the education is, if there is no material to Oh my God. I mean, I brought him from like, from the minus nothing to high above to amazing. And then there was a part where he split from the honesty. There's nothing I could do about it. I don't know what it is, the ground material. So look at the liquors around. They don't want to look inside, so they rather lie and cheat. They lie to me, to themselves, to the children, to anybody. That is not a place to live. Demons again, if you want, or any place I had been working. They look at my sincerity and my honesty. Simplicity, you might say. But simplicity in terms of sencillo in Spanish. Easygoing. Because I don't command you to read important books to talk with me. I get it. There's something else. It's more the humanistic aspect. But you must look and educate yourself in a way. To build strength for yourself. And then there's the part of appreciating. I don't want to comment on the people who have children right now because it's absolutely unacceptable. Because there is no space for children, and these parents, they don't have space to look inside themselves, so they're gonna manipulate their children around or abandon them or both of it. It's not applicable. They don't have time to educate themselves. If they have time to educate themselves as children, then they're not good parents. And then what about the guilt? What about the guilt? Now I get a little hint. Kühnert had children and he felt guilty because he didn't have paid attention to them. I don't know. Was that so? I went to his house. I opened the door. I see a large living room. Yeah, because his wife gave me the keys. Because I went on vacation and wanted me to have a look. I think it only happened once. One vacation where I went, maybe a few times. I looked at the living room. I don't remember having opened the doors of the rooms. Maybe I should have, maybe I did, but I don't remember details. Maybe I didn't feel it was necessary to open the individual rooms. Just to maybe make presents in front of the house and go in, and I don't know. I did not spend much time there. Because there was nothing to do. Look, open the door, look, it's all in order, it's all neat and clean, orderly, it's all good. So I go back out, I lock the door, I drive away. And that is what this is. The people around me, they don't have respect. They don't have respect for me, for my time or for my life, or for the possessions they take from me. And they were given by Green, not by my authorization. Because they're walking into their demise, not looking at what's happening. I would not do that to anybody.